Subscribe to TechEmpty by clicking the subscribe button and tap on the bell icon to get all my latest awesome tech video updates.
Hello YouTube, this is Praveen for TechEmpty. In this video, I'll be showing you the 15 WhatsApp tricks that you should know. These tricks are for both Android and iOS users. So without any further ado, let's get started.
First one here in the list is pinning the chat conversation. Gone are those days searching for the list of groups or conversations that you involve frequently. Instead, just pin the conversation to the top of the WhatsApp so that you can get in touch with the people instantly. To do this, long press the chat conversation and select the pin icon at the top. This trick is only for the Android users, and iOS users may get this in coming days. To unpin, repeat the same steps. Second one for Android, add the shortcut. Would you like to chat with the people that you most concern about without opening the WhatsApp app? Do this by creating a shortcut. Long press the chat of your friend or family, select the options, and here choose Add Shortcut. Now you can interact with people by directly choosing the shortcut you just created from the home screen. Cool, isn't it? Third one, hiding last seen, profile picture, about, and status. You can change the privacy settings of the WhatsApp to hide the last seen, profile picture, about, and the status messages. To do that, you just need to go to WhatsApp, then choose Options, then Settings, then Account, then Privacy. Here you will have the options to choose whether you want your last seen, profile picture, about, and status to be seen by everyone, contacts, or nobody. If you are an iPhone user, then move to Settings, then Account, then Privacy, and here choose the appropriate option whether to show your last seen, profile picture, about, and status by everyone, contacts, or nobody. Remember, if you don't share your last seen, you won't be able to see other people's last seen. Fourth one, read receipts. Do you know about those blue ticks? That is called read receipts. When you read some message, the sender will get those blue ticks, meaning that you have read the message that they sent. Of course, it can create some relationship issues. Well, WhatsApp understands that, and there is an option to turn it off. To turn this off entirely, go to Settings, then Account, then Privacy, and come all the way down and find Read Receipts. Just toggle it to turn it off. Now the sender won't get any acknowledgement when you read the message. Remember, if you turn off Read Receipts, you too will not be able to view anyone else's Read Receipts. Fifth one, check when a message was read. You can check when the sent message was read by the receiver. It is simple, as all you need to do is press hold on a message and tap info. Once you do that, you will be able to see the time when your message was delivered and read. On an iPhone, just swipe to the left to check the status. Sixth one, hide chats. Do you know that you can hide chats without using any third-party apps? Let me tell you. Just mark the chat conversation as archive and the whole contact will not be shown on the WhatsApp home screen. If you are an Android user, long press on the chat and select this archive icon. To unarchive, open the archived conversations and then again long press on the chat, then choose unarchive. If you are an iPhone user, swipe the conversation to the left and find archive. Choose it to hide the chat conversation. To unarchive, swipe down the WhatsApp window and choose Archive Chats. Here select the conversation, then swipe left to unarchive it. Seventh one, send GIFs. Are you getting GIF messages from your friends? Don't you know how to send them? No worries, here I am. You don't have to search the internet for appropriate GIFs. WhatsApp has its own collection. If you are an Android user, then select this emoji icon, then choose GIF. Select the best and send it to your friends or family. And if you are an iPhone user, choose the plus icon and choose Photo and Video Library. Here choose GIF at the bottom corner and send the best one. Eighth one, mute groups and notifications. Groups on WhatsApp are a great way to message a lot of people at once, but they can get annoying sometimes. Well, there are options to mute a group and you can also stop getting notifications. To mute a group, long press on the chat and choose Group Info. You can turn on mute for 8 hours, a week, or even a year. On Android, you also get an option to turn off show notifications while muting a group. However, on an iPhone, you can only mute a group chat. Ninth one, star messages. Let's say someone sent you a quotation and you loved it. After a few months, you need to get that quote again from the long conversation. It's really a tough thing to do, right? This is where the star messages rescue you. Just mark the quote as star message and you can check it anytime by moving to the profile, then star messages. Tenth one, send a message in bulk. On various occasions, it's a great hassle to go on wishing the people individually, which makes WhatsApp's broadcast feature all the more useful. WhatsApp's broadcast feature lets you send messages in bulk without the recipients knowing that it has been sent through WhatsApp's broadcast. On Android, choose the three dots and select New Broadcast. Now pick the contacts of minimum two that you would like to broadcast a message. On iPhone, find the broadcast list and create a new list. Choose the recipients of minimum 2 and maximum of 256 to send a broadcast message. 11th one, change font. Surprise your friends by sending the text message with this cool new font. Just add the three grave accent characters at the start and end of the message. If you are an iPhone user, find the grave accent character by holding the apostrophe. And if you are an Android user, find this character in the second page of symbols or punctuation. 12th one, text formatting. Now you can format the text using some special characters. This comes handy when you would like to highlight something in the sentence. Use star at the start and the end of the word to bold it, underscore for italics, and tilde for strike through. 13th one, tagging the person. Now WhatsApp allows you to tag the members within the group chat. You can use this feature if you would like to say something by referring a person. Just type at the red symbol, then choose the name from the list. That's it. 14th one, quote a WhatsApp message. If you are actively involved in a conversation having number of people, it is often confusing at times as to who someone is referring to in a group chat. So use this feature to embed the previous text in your reply. To use, press and hold the message, then choose reply. If you are using an Android device, press and hold the message, then choose the reply icon at the top. 15th one, hop into an individual chat from a group chat. How many group chats are you in right now? Plenty, we bet. Given that you can have up to 256 participants in one group chat, there must be a bit of overlap with your existing individual chats. And sometimes there are things you want to say to someone that should never be mentioned in a group, but it's also a pain to go locate that individual chat. There's a simple way to start an individual chat quickly from a group one. Long press on a message of the person that you would like to speak in private. Choose message to the person name and you will be teleported right into that individual chat without you having to scroll the list of chats. In Android, tap and hold the message of the person and choose the three dots at the top right corner.
That's it. Which is your favorite trick? Drop them in the comment section. If you find this video useful, hit the like button down below and consider sharing this video with your friends. Also, don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more awesome videos like these. Your contribution is more to us. This is Praveen signing off. Hope to see you in my next video. Thank you.